Introducing the man who strikes fear into the hearts of atheists and unbelievers around the world. The man whose power spear of reason and jackhammer of truth has defeated all comers by the power of the Holy Spirit. That man is the Christian Road Warrior.
Hey, it's I, the Warrior Guy. And you know what I'm gonna say. I'm back to slap down Reggie, the Infidel Guy, just a little bit more. Because he just recently did a new video talking about the power of prayer, like he knows anything about that. That's right, I'm back, and I'm back for the, hey, not for the warrior, I'm the warrior, I'm back, and I'm still black, you got that, Jack? That's right, the warrior can rhyme, but this time, Reggie wants to come on and talk about prayer. Cut the music! I tell you, Reggie wants to talk about prayer, as if he knows anything about that. Now, I'm just making a little adjustment. Now, Mr. Reggie Finley, the so-called Infidel Guy, well, meet the Warrior Guy. And I'm in your face, Reggie, once again. Just made a new video talking about the power of prayer. So we're going to get right into some clips just to see what he's talking about. Then I'm going to slap that nonsense around just like I did before in the other videos. It's going to be a slap, slippity slap, good time.
Now, prayer. Many people believe that prayer does work. And it's so intriguing to me how, in the face of evidence, negative evidence, people will still say that prayer works. And there really isn't really much evidence there. I think kind of people are picking and choosing what they wish to accept.
Oh, man, Reggie. Yeah, that's real funny, man. You're cracking me up over here. But I think the boo birds are coming out to get you again. That's right. You don't know what you're talking about, Reggie. Okay, so you want to talk about, well, prayer. And some people believe it works. Well, you know, here's the thing, Reggie. It's not so much that prayer works. It's that there's a God who exists that answers prayer. It's not so much that the prayer works. God works and answers prayer. That's the first thing. The second thing is, you want to talk about people, you know, in the face of negative evidence? Come on. You guys are the kings and queens of whenever there's evidence against your little pet, I'm an atheist, I don't believe in God theory. You know, you pick and choose what you want to believe. You know, and it's funny how you always seem to pick and choose on the side that would seem to lend credibility to your atheism. That's interesting. You know, you're talking about this, you know, negative evidence. I'm sure you're probably referring to maybe that recent prayer study in that I saw referred to in Dawkins' delusion book. Excuse me, the Dawkins' God Delusion book, where, you know, he says, you know, well, it's quite not effective. Of course it didn't work. Well, that's interesting. You know, this is something relatively new, you know, actually doing tests on prayer. Now, you'd think that if something's been going on for like thousands, I'm just being generous here, thousands of years, people praying. I've only been a Christian 20 years. I've had multiple answered prayer. I'd like to think that here's the crux of it. And like I said, I'm toning down the warrior voice a little bit, but I'm still the warrior, and you're not going to forget it. But, you know, I'm not going to let you forget it. But the crux of the matter is this, people. If there is no God, there should be zero. You see that? Zero answered prayer. Not, oh, you know, one or two. No. No God, no answered prayer. Especially, you know, in terms of specific answered prayer and detailed answered prayer. So, you know, you want to just dismiss things out of hand. You want to talk about maybe one or two prayer studies. I mean, there are prayer studies where there was significant differences. You know, the bird prayer study is one of them where there was, I don't remember all the details now, but there was enough significant difference in the prayed for group than the the control group. I mean, but you know, of course, that must be ignored, or some rationalization or ad hoc rescue must be thrown at that. You know, it must be picked apart so that you can sustain your atheism. See, I've seen this stuff all before. Okay, you know, it's I don't even know what to call it at this point, but basically, you're doing everything it takes, you know, and that's actually, I do know what to call it. It's called, you know, cutting off your head. You know, if God heals your eyes, don't cut off your head. That's the title of my book, Refuting Atheism and Unbelief, because that's what you do. You know, it's not that there's no evidence. You know, I know the old atheistic mantra, there is no evidence, there is no evidence. I hear that crap all the time, and it's just rationalized crap. It's not that there's no evidence. You rationalize it away. You know, how can we have people on this planet that deny the Holocaust? There's plenty of evidence for the Holocaust, but guess what? They rationalize it away, just like atheists rationalize away evidence for God. It's only worse in their case. But let's get back to some more of the nonsense. And I think I'll only be able to get to maybe one clip, but there's going to be a series of refutations of this nonsense by Mr. Infidel Guy. Let's get back to another clip. Well, it looks like I've run out of time, but I'll be back for part two of refuting the Infidel Guy and his mistakes and errors on the power of prayer.